to the How to Use Your Life show, the world's only show helping you use your life to the fullest. I'm your host, Joe Fermano, and tonight, Life's a Cartwheel, my latest video blog, and foods that put you in a good mood. Yeah, yum yum. And the 10 habits you must quit if you want to be happy. And Jack Canfield, author of Chicken Soup of the Soul, Why People Are Not Successful. Straight ahead, the How to Use Your Life show.
I have found, for when my chin is on the ground, I pick myself up, dust myself off, and start all over again.
And good evening, folks, and welcome back. I'm Joe Fermano, your host every Tuesday night, 7 p.m. Eastern Time, the How to Use Your Life show, broadcasting absolutely live from our Philadelphia, New Jersey studios, WNJC, 1360 a.m. on the dial, or, of course, anywhere in the free world. Just go to www.WNJC1360.com. And hey, I gotta tell you, I did good. I gotta remember, I'm on Facebook. I gotta tell you that, you know, my media studio musician, technician, just genius of a guy, keeps saying, Joe, you gotta use a social media thing. So before you know it, I'll be tweeting too. But I've been trying to, so you can follow me at Facebook. That's what I'm saying. And I've been trying to send out messages on Facebook that, hey, here we are live each week. Okay. My website is joefermano.com. Got a lot of little stuff to, well, a lot of little stuff that may make a big difference to you, because after all, that's the concept of the How to Use Your Life show, where each week I go out and try to gather up as many stories or ideas or concepts or interviews, which, by the way, starting in the fall, we're really filling up the docket here. So get ready for a lot of great shows. Anyway, I go out and I gather this stuff. I throw it up against a proverbial, hopefully positive, inspirational, motivational wall. And something sticks to you. Something gets you going. Something inspires you. Maybe enough to go to my website, joefermano.com, and sign up for the free newsletter, which is nothing but the daily dose. Every morning, you'll wake up, hopefully, to an inspiring, positive quote, and then once a week or so, you'll get the video blog. Speaking of video blogs, yesterday just came at me real quick. I rush home, and this week's video blog, Life's a Cartwheel. And my daughter, Grace, I mean, I've got the two boys, but like they say, man, daddy's a little girl. She's 6 years old. I'm not even put my briefcase down. I walk in the house, daddy, look what I'm doing. Look what I can do. I'm like, wow, Gracie, what is it? And there she's in there showing me all proud how she's been practicing all day her cartwheels and her handstands. So I said, come on, honey, let me video you. So I videoed that. And then after that, I did my little commentary, my little 2 cents over like a 2 minute segment, and just talked about the fact that, hey, man, when's the last time you flipped over something in your life? When's the last time you did something for the first time? When? What are you doing? What inspires you? What jazzes you up? What gets you going? Your juices flowing in your life that you could do a cartwheel over or just get so excited about that you can't wait to tell somebody about. I don't care how old you get. I mean, I've got clients that I advise in their 90s that come to me and say, hold on, Joe, I got to see if I can fit you in. You know, we got the Bye Bye Birdie production that I'm doing. I'm doing the dance thing. And I got to play Mahjong. Is that what it's called? Mahjong? You know what I'm talking about. Oh, Bocce. I got the Bocce club later today. Mahjong, whatever it's called. Anyway, there's always something to look forward to if you choose to do so. For example, and I'm throwing this story in. I didn't put it up today on the site, and I didn't talk about it on Facebook. But have you heard this story? And I'm just throwing this out there. Did you hear a story about Diane Nyad? I think I'm pronouncing it right. Diane Nyad, N-Y-A-D. NYAD. Did you hear about her? The 62-year-old woman who wanted to swim, who attempted to swim from Florida to Cuba. Cuba, this has been a dream. Listen to this. I just found this article, and I just have to share this because after, while I was in the green room waiting to get on the air tonight, I looked up the story. I'm like, oh, I wish, you know, I could call her and just get her on the show. So maybe we will eventually. But here's what happened. Endurance swimmer Diane Nyad's latest attempt to swim across the Straits of Florida ended Tuesday morning. This morning, after severe jellyfish stings and a lightning storm put her off course. She had been in the water for 60 hours and was about halfway through the swim from Cuba to Florida. Now, the swim's 103 miles, so do the math. She was halfway through. Nyad, and the reason why I want to read you part of the story, because it gets better. Nyad was stung by jellyfish overnight, and a major lightning storm put anyone in the water in extreme danger, said Mark Stollinger, Nyad's operations chief. He said the 62-year-old exhausted swimmer was pulled out as the dangers mounted. Quote, with all the threats continuing, Diane decided that it was a risk that she just did not want to take. Her lips and face were swollen, but she's holding up, as well as someone who's just spent 63 hours performing a monumental and extremely dangerous feat. So they go on to talk about the fact that he said, look, and this is her chief, the guy that kind of followed her along with the boat, make sure she's kind of doing okay. He said, you know, you can describe her achievement as huge, despite having to stop before she reached Florida. It's a cross between being down, being so tired because everyone wanted this so much, and a huge sense of accomplishment, he said. Nobody in the world would even attempt this, but we did. Diane was making her fourth attempt, folks, to swim across the Straits of Florida. Again, the full distance from Havana, Cuba, to Key West, Florida is 103 miles. So what happened is on Saturday night, her first night in the water, her first night, now this is Tuesday, okay? She was stung by jellyfish on her lips, forehead, hands, and neck. And the next night, I mean, they had a big squall blew through and threw her off course. So the article goes on and on. And as I'm leading on, I'm thinking, okay, tonight I'm going to present this to the listeners of the How to Use Your Life show on WNJC. Talk about the fact that here's this woman, 62, about to be 63 years old, and she's out there pursuing her dream. Well, as I read along, they talk about the fact that in the 1970s, she won multiple swimming marathons and was the first woman to swim around the island of Manhattan. And she holds a world record for the longest ocean swim, which is 102 and a half miles. Okay, Nyad, well, here's my point. Diane said she was 8 years old when she first dreamed. Remember that, folks? Remember some of your dreams about swimming across Florida. At the time, she said she was in Cuba on a trip from her home in Florida in the 1950s, before Fidel Castro led the communist takeover and blah, blah, blah. She said, I used to stand on the beach and I said to my mother, I wonder, Mom, if anyone could swim over there. And she recalled saying and pointing to the Keys and never forgot it. So in her 60s, she said she still feels vital and powerful and definitely not old. A successful swim ideally will inspire people her age, she said, and older, not to let their age hinder them. Then she goes on to say, and I just caught this at the end of this article. There's a ton of articles out there. They quote her, when I walk on that shore in Florida, I want millions of those, you listening, folks, AARP sisters and brothers to look at me and say, I'm going to go write that novel. It's never too late. I'm going to go work in Africa on that farm that those people need help at. I'm going to adopt a child. It's not too late. I can still live my dreams. You go, Diane. Now, to me, because she had to stop halfway through and got stung all over her face and forehead by these by the jellyfish, the fact that she just attempted it and went halfway through, what do you think? You know, go on Facebook and comment or email me at joe@joefermano.com. It's a success story in herself. She's 62 years old, and she went for it. And I love the fact that at the end, she built up to what I was going to talk about, and that's the fact that, hey, whatever your dream is, whatever your goal has been, it's never too late to do it. So remember that. Cherish that. So, so true. Hey, when we first started out tonight on the intro, I talked about the fact that foods that put you in a good mood. Well, let me talk to you about what doesn't. In from the medical web, medweb.com, are trans fats affecting your mood? Now, as you know, folks, quite often, I'm always doing something on health because I don't care what you say. You can go on and research. Oh, gosh. It was Dr. Kenneth Davis from Mount Sinai Hospital in Manhattan who was on television the other day, and he said, you know, we tax alcohol, we tax tobacco, we need to tax sugar, we need to tax fructose and corn syrup. It's killing people. Obesity is killing people. Anyway, that's another story for another time. So this article says, you know, like Godzilla strolling through a Japanese fishing village, trans fats destroy your streets and highways, meaning, you know, akin to your blood vessels, okay, and your heart and your brain. They can affect your heart and brain. They also make your real age, get this, much, much older. They're like super bullets that negatively impact your mood. So they go on to say, you know, if you're sending your kid off to school or you head to work after breakfast of a trans fat sugar like a tart or a sweet roll or, you know what I'm talking about, all the sweet stuff, our advice is to read the food labels to avoid prepared foods and baked goods. And here's what you should do every day. The fact that if you just opt for any kind of fresh fruit and whole grains, such foods power the body and brain for sharper thinking. Just adding apples can make the difference. Nuts. Just say nuts. Go nuts. Sprinkle chopped walnuts, almonds, and other nuts on your morning meal if you want, or just grab a couple handfuls of almonds. Makes all the difference in the world. The vitamins, the minerals help your head, almost like fish oil does, and get your vitamin C. A little bit of sun doesn't hurt. You know, it could be a little bit of orange juice, but the polyphenols in orange juice or vitamin C reduce stress. All right, that's it. That's my take on Dr. Joe. Okay, I'm not going to beat you up about it, but the reason why I'm talking about that, because it does matter. All this stuff that I tell you about focusing and the 10 keys to success and never give up and balance your life. What good is it if you got a Ferrari but there's no engine in it, where the engine is polluted, so you don't want to pollute your engine? Okay, here's what we're going to do. We're going to take a brief break. When we return, we're going to get into tonight's main story, 10 habits that you got to quit now, if and only if you want to be happy. I'm Joe Fermano. You're tuned to the How to Use Your Life show. We'll be right back. All right, welcome back, folks. I'm Joe Fermano. You're tuned to the How to Use Your Life show, WNJC 1360 AM and 1360.com. Okay. There are lots of things you can do to be happy, but I never thought of it in this way, positioning it in what things should you not do or things you need to quit to be happy. So I think it's a lot catchier. So, you know, when you, I guess, quit doing the wrong things, you make more room for the things that make you happy, right? So, for example, quit procrastinating on your goals. So here's a great quote. Some people dream of success while others, what? Stay awake and make it happen. Action and change are often resisted when they're needed the most. Okay, so get a hold of yourself and have some discipline. Putting off something instantly makes it harder and scarier. What's it? There's a book out there called Eat the Frog First, meaning, you know, the stuff that you don't like, it's kind of like I tell the kids, okay, eat the lima bean now. Eat the lima beans first, and then you can have your ice cream, you know? Anyway, don't start today don't start today. Won't be finished by tomorrow, if you know what I mean. And there's nothing more stressful than the perpetual lingering of an unfinished task. It weighs you down. It's like clutter. The secret to getting ahead is simply getting started. Starting all by itself is usually sufficient to build enough momentum to keep the ball rolling. So forget about the finish line, and really in the beginning, just concentrate on taking your first step. Okay? Just do it. Say to yourself, I choose to start this task with a small, imperfect step. All these small steps will add up, and you'll actually get to see changes fairly quickly. Secondly, quit blaming others and making excuses. Everybody's guilty of this. I mean, you may not even think you do, but you do. Stop blaming others for what you have or don't have, or for what you feel or don't feel. When you blame others for what you're going through, you deny responsibility and perpetuate the problem. Stop giving your power away. Just like I tell you, don't let anyone steal your joy. Don't give your power away. And start taking responsibility for your life. Blaming is just another sorry excuse, and making excuses is the first step towards failure. You and only you are responsible for your life choices and decisions. Should I repeat that? Yeah, sure, okay. You and only you are responsible for your life choices and decisions. Number three, quit trying to avoid change. Wow, the one thing that remains constant, right? If nothing ever changed, there would be no sunrise the next morning. It's one way to put it. Most of us are comfortable right where we are, even though the whole universe is constantly changing around us. Learning to accept that this is vital to our happiness and general success. Because, only when we change do we grow and begin to see a world we never knew was possible. And don't forget, however good or bad a situation is, it will change. It always does. I try to live with the idea that nothing's as good or bad as it seems. And again, things will change. And that's the one thing you can count on. So embrace it and realize that change happens for a reason. It won't always be easy or obvious at first, but in the end, it'll be worth it. Number four, quit trying to control the uncontrollable. You know, if you try to control everything and then worry about the things you can't control, you're setting yourself up for a lifetime of frustration and misery. I wonder if you know anybody like that. I know I do. Anyway, myself, some forces are out of your control, but you can control how you react to things. See, that's the God-given will that we have. It's not what happens. It's how you choose to respond to what happens. Everyone's life has positive and negative aspects, right? Whether you're happy or not depends greatly on which aspects you focus on. The best thing you can do is to let go of what you can't control and invest your energy in the things you can, like your attitude. When I'm having a tough day and things aren't going right, I get right back. I say, I'm going to write another chapter, work on another chapter, and some more research of my book. I'm going to work on this idea, something I know that just is going to come easier to me, and it's my little space. Number five, quit talking down to yourself. Big one. Quit talking down to yourself. Nothing will bring you down quicker than berating yourself. The mind is a superb instrument if used right, but when used incorrectly, it becomes very destructive. Be aware of your self-talk, your mental self-talk. We all talk silently to ourselves, in our heads and even subconsciously, but we aren't always conscious of what we're saying or how it's affecting us. As Henry Ford said, whether you think you can or think you can't, you're right. One of the major causes I know that we fail is due to self-doubt and negative self-talk. The way to overcome negative thoughts and destructive emotions is to develop opposing positive emotions that are stronger and more powerful. In other words, listen to your self-talk and replace negative thoughts with positive ones. Over time, you will change the trajectory, okay, of your life. You can do that. You say, no. Instead of, like, when you're laying in bed at night, I got to do this tomorrow. I didn't do this. No. Did what I had to do today. Okay. Thank you. I'm going to do great tomorrow. I'm going to give it my best tomorrow. Here's what I am going to accomplish. I'm going to go at it again. Here are the things I did do. Here are the things I tried to do. There's nothing I can do about it. It's in the past, right? Number six, quit criticizing others. The negativity you bleed out toward others will gradually cripple your own happiness. Not good. When you feel comfortable with your own imperfections, you won't feel threatened or offended by the imperfections you see in other people. So stop worrying about the flaws you see in everyone else and focus on yourself. Let the constant growth and improvement in your own life keep you so busy that you have no time left to criticize others. Number seven, quit running. And folks, we're talking about the things you got to just quit, okay, to be happy. Quit running from your problems and fears. Again, something a lot of us can do. Trust me, if everyone threw their problems into a pile for you to see, you would grab yours back probably. You know, you want to bet? Tackle your problems and fears swiftly. Don't run away from them. The best solution is to face them head on, no matter how powerful they may seem. You know, fears in particularly, I don't know, they freeze, they stop you from taking chances and making decisions, right? They keep you confined to just a small place where, oh, okay, I feel comfortable here, warm and fuzzy. But your life story is simply the culmination of many small, unique experiences. And I tell you, moments, right? Life's made up of the moments, many of which require you to stretch your comfort zone. Letting your fears and worries control you is not living, folks. It's merely what? Yeah, you got it. It's merely existing. Number eight, quit living in another time and place. Yeah, this is definitely a good one. Some people spend their entire lives trying to live in another time and place. What do I mean? They lament about what has been, what they could have done, what they might become, shoulda, coulda, woulda. However, the past is gone, and the future doesn't exist. No matter how much time we spend thinking and lamenting about either, it doesn't change anything. One of life's sharpest paradoxes is that our brightest future hinges on our ability to pay attention to what we're doing right now, today. We need to live more in the moment. You know, the power of now. Living in the moment requires active, open, intentional awareness on the present. Like I always say, if you work in on the moment, the future is going to take care of itself. You just don't realize it. That's what life is made up of. So don't fantasize about being on vacation while at work, and don't worry about the work piling up on your desk when you're on vacation. Manage that. Live for now. Notice the beauty, if you will, really, unfolding around you. Number nine, quit trying to be someone you're not. One of the greatest challenges in life is being in a world that's trying to make you like everyone else. Okay, someone's always going to be prettier. Someone will always be smarter. Someone will always be younger, but they'll never be you. So don't change so people will like you. And number 10 of the things you got to quit to be happy here on the How to Use Your Life show. Quit being ungrateful. Not all the puzzles of life will seem to fit together at first, but in time, I really believe you will realize they do perfectly. So thank the things that didn't work out, because they just made room for the things that will. Get it? And thank the ones who walked away from you, because they just made room for the ones who won't. So no matter how good or bad you have it, wake up each day thankful for your life. Someone somewhere else is desperately fighting for theirs. So instead of thinking about what you're missing, try thinking about what you have that everyone else is missing. And hopefully that's a great attitude from tuning into the How to Use Your Life show. Folks, we'll be back next week. I'm Joe Fermano, tuned to the How to Use Your Life show. Check me out. Follow me on Facebook. Go to my website, joefermano.com. I'm all over YouTube. This is Joe Fermano saying good night, good attitudes, and God bless America. Liberating strife. Who more than self?